So far, we've been using ODE integrators to integrate one first order ODE. Often you have to integrate second order ODEs because Newton's method, F equals MA, is a second order ODE. And then often one has to integrate systems of differential equations, not just a single differential equation, but coupled groups of differential equations that form a system. So let's first start by seeing how you would integrate a second order differential equation. So let's say we have a differential equation x double dot d squared x dt squared is some function of t, x, and then the derivative can also depend on x dot, or the second derivative of x can also depend on the first derivative of x. Okay, the trick here is to define a new variable. We let some new variable u, like velocity, equal dx dt, x dot, and then to construct a system of first order equations using this new variable. So the first equation would be x dot equals u, and then the second equation would be u dot. U dot is x double dot, so that's equal to f. So that's equal to f of t x, and then instead of x dot here, we already define x dot to be u, so that would be u. So this would be a converting a single second order differential equation into two first order equations, okay? So we need to generalize the Runge-Kutta method to solve a system of first order equations. Because this is in general true. If this was a third order differential equation, we can convert it into three coupled first order equations, okay? So let's do that in general. Let's look at a system of first order equations. So I'll write down x dot equals f of t, x, and then another variable, y. And y dot equals g of t, x, and y. So this is a more general form of a system of two coupled first order equations. So we have an equation for dx dt that depends on t, x, and y, and an equation for dy dt that also depends on t, x, and y. So we can integrate that. We can use a second order Runge-Kutta method, say the modified Euler method. So we'll integrate using the modified Euler method. And the trick here is that you have to integrate these two first order ODEs in parallel. So we can use k for the stages for the integrating of x, and we can use l for the stages for the integrating of y. So we could write k1 equals delta t times f of tn, xn, yn. And at the same time, we would write L1 equals delta t times g of tn, xn, yn. Okay, so we're going to integrate in parallel. Then the second stage of this RK2 method would be K2. So here, K2 would be equal to delta t times f. And then we would go Tn plus delta t. And then we would go Xn, and we need to then increment Xn. We need to use K1, because this is F here. We need to use K1 to increment Xn, so Xn plus K1. And then we need to use L1 to increment Yn, so Yn plus L1, okay? At the same time, we need L2. So L2 here, let me put it here, L2 would be delta t times g. And the arguments here would be the same. So Tn plus delta t xn plus k1 yn plus l1. Okay? So basically, the way to do this is that you're doing these two first-order ODEs in parallel. So x would be the k's, and y would be the l's. And then we would solve then. So we would have xn plus 1 equals xn, and then we average the k's, so 1 half k1 plus k2, and yn plus 1 then is equal to yn plus 1 half L1 plus L2, okay? Not that complicated. So let me review. A lot of the time, you have to solve a second order ODE and not a first order ODE. You can convert a second order ODE or even coupled second order ODEs into a system of first order ODEs. If you want to integrate a system of first order ODEs, here I show you an example with two coupled first order ODEs. You basically apply your integration method in parallel, okay? So you basically, you're integrating the x1 using the k's, and you're integrating the x's using the k's, and you're integrating the y's using the L's. So at each stage, you need to compute K1 and L1 at stage 1, and K2 and L2 at stage 2. And then you use the K's to increment the X's, and the L's to increment the Y's. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.